Few things mean more to me than the ocean. I grew up in Panama. I also grew up with a family that was very interested in environmental issues. In particular, my mom worked in conservation. The marine studies degree is a degree I would have done as an undergrad, really looking at the issues from the suite of liberal arts perspective. So we can look at things from a literature perspective. What does literature tell us about the marine environment, about from a historical perspective, from a culture and anthropology perspective, right? Policy, which is what I do. I worked for a couple of years with NOAA's National Marine Protected Area Center. I am currently looking at how coastal communities, specifically industry related to shellfish growing or other kind of species that are affected by climate change, I'm thinking about how they're adapting to these global environmental changes. It was a challenging path. There was uncertainty about whether there would be career opportunities for somebody with an interdisciplinary social science background. So in other words, I combine aspects of anthropology, aspects of human geography, of sociology, even of political science and economics, and apply it to issues along the coast. It's not a clear path, which is one of the most exciting things about the Marine Studies Initiative. It's grounded in solid knowledge of the environment, but grounded in that human dimension element. Most issues in the environment do not happen in isolation of human activities, nor do human activities occur in isolation of natural and environmental processes. All the different threats that are occurring to our ocean spaces these days need to be looked at from this interdisciplinary perspective. Not only are we mixing or putting together two perspectives, but we're also grounding the issue from a real-world perspective.